Hello, friends. I'm very thankful that we can come to you with this special presentation. I'm here with a friend, Dr. Neil Nedley, who is the president of the Weimar Institute, as well as an internist and a specialist in how to prevent getting disease and build up your immune system. As we all know, Dr. Nedley, the news has been filled. It's been ubiquitous, talking about the coronavirus and the COVID-19.
Right.
And people are wondering, what can they do? What practical things can we do? It doesn't look like it's leaving the news cycle because new cases are being found. As of the time of this recording, a school just south of us here in Sacramento was closed down, even though there were no local cases. They closed down the school. 6 million people quarantined in Italy. There may be still millions quarantined in China. The word we're hearing is that folks might just expect that it's going to continue to spread. So I want to thank you for joining us today, but if I'm correct, there is at this point no imminent vaccine or no immediate vaccine available.
That's correct. It won't be for at least a year. So yeah, unlike the flu virus, nothing you can do to get vaccinated on this one.
Just covering some of the common questions that are coming in, this is a similar virus to a flu virus. I guess it comes from a family of viruses that are of similar nature. But would you say that the COVID-19 is more or less contagious than the common flu?
Seems to be a little more transmissible. You know, the average individual with the flu will transmit it to a little more than one person on average. And the average person with coronavirus is transmitting it to a little more than two. So it makes it a little more transmissible, probably double the transmission rate.
Now, if I understand right, you and I were talking off air. You said that part of that might be because some people have it and they're not showing serious symptoms, but they are carrying it and they don't know.
Exactly. And this is why this virus is going to spread. You know, unlike SARS or Ebola, where virtually everybody got sick and you could contain it and, you know, contain those sick people, 80% of people getting this virus are not really getting that sick. Maybe a mild cold, maybe a sore throat and it goes away, or maybe no symptoms at all. A lot of people with healthy immune systems, they have no symptoms at all, but yet they're transmitting the virus unknowingly. And so that makes it tough. Only less than 20% actually get sick enough to seek care, mm-hmm. You know, and go to a hospital. And those are individuals normally that have the pneumonia. And that's, of course, much more serious because the pneumonia can go into acute respiratory distress syndrome. And that's why the deaths are occurring.
And then from what I've seen is compared to, I know a lot of people every year die from the common flu because it's pretty much everywhere. But with the coronavirus, they say it may be as high as like 2.3% or 3%. They're still gathering figures. Death rate.
Right. Yeah, and it's probably going to be less than that because that's figures on the ones that are known cases.
That's
and
right.
Just like I mentioned, since so many are not actually coming down with many symptoms and they haven't been tested, the death rate of coronavirus is probably going to be less than that. But we do think at this time that the death rates are probably higher than the flu.
Now, since there is no immediate cure or vaccine for this, people are wondering, well, if it comes to a neighborhood near you, what I'm hearing is they're figuring eventually it is going to continue to spread.
Yeah.
That if it comes to a neighborhood near you, what can you do? For one thing, will the summer season help slow the spread as, you know, flu season, I guess, is typically worse in the winter.
We expect it will probably slow in the summer because of the heat and all of the sunlight. You know, sunlight is antiviral, and of course, sunlight helps our immune system with vitamin D. And just like the flu goes away in the summertime, many experts are thinking this will likely occur. Although, since it's a novel virus, we're not absolutely sure until mm-hmm. time does occur.
You know, that's an excellent segue. Your specialty is at the Institute teaching a program that's world famous right now called NEWSTART, which is talking about certain natural things a person can do to improve their immunity and improve their health overall.
Exactly.
Why don't you explain what NEWSTART is real quick?
Well, NEWSTART is an acronym that Weimar has trademarked, and it's very easy to remember these eight principles that have been shown to be very immune enhancing. Proper nutrition is the N, the E is exercise, the W is water, which is being talked a lot about in the coronavirus. The S is sunlight. The T is temperance. That means avoiding things that are harmful to the immune system, like alcohol and tobacco. The A is air. And of course, fresh air is a great way not to get the virus. There's virtually no cases spread, you know, outdoors. And then R is rest, proper rest, which means getting enough sleep. And then T is trust in divine power, which is actually shown to also be immune enhancing. So if we have eight of these principles together, we can expect that our immune system will make us one of the ones, if we're exposed to it, one of the ones with no symptoms or maybe just mild symptoms.
Yeah, well, that's very encouraging. So there's a chance we could be in that 70 or 80% that may be exposed. Now, if a person is exposed to coronavirus and they're able to resist it, they're developing, if I'm not mistaken, certain antibodies that help prevent them in the future.
Exactly. Yeah, those antibodies will be protective of them in the future, and that's actually better than getting the vaccine when you've gotten the real thing and your body's fought it off.
Now, we were talking, some of these viruses that are spreading, you know, some folks are saying, well, was this, you know, a bioweapon that the Chinese or somebody was developing? And I think that the general belief is no, this has happened before with these viruses mutating and they're being caught from animals.
Correct.
But not just any animals. Typically, animals the Bible would normally tell us are unclean animals.
Exactly. That's why God told us to stay away from these, was to prevent epidemics in nations and throughout the world. And so virtually every epidemic, whether it was the SARS virus, Ebola, AIDS, they all have the signature that they started from actually eating unclean meat. And because we're an unclean animal, we spread that readily. So this is why if we can get infection from a cow, we might die from that, but we're not going to spread it to other human beings. And so eating unclean meat is really unresponsible, because if you get an infection from unclean meat, you're going to readily spread that to other humans who are actually innocent. You know, they're not eating that. And of course, we can trace it to the actual supermarket and the person who first contracted this from unclean animals. And in coronavirus case, it was a bat.
Now, when we talk about the some of the things that people can do, you know, there's been some practical information given. Of course, I guess the same things that you would follow when it comes to the common flu is be more careful with the washing, sanitizing, avoid certain congested places, especially if you're in an area that has been identified as, you know, where there's community spread. But so there's things we can do to increase our immune system by following the NEWSTART principles.
Yeah, the nutrition, antioxidant foods. Your high antioxidant foods in vegetables and in fruit will actually help us. So these are your cruciferous vegetables, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, and the greens are very potent in antioxidants. Spinach, kale is the number two antioxidant vegetable, and the number one is garlic. And garlic even has some very strong antiviral activity and can even take care of viruses itself, plus it can help our immune system with that. And the fruits are going to be primarily your berries and the whole fruit that actually has the most antioxidants that are not berries is the simple plum. And so these are things that can actually protect our immune system and help us fight these things off.
You know, I'm so glad that you've come in to share this with us. There are a lot of different videos going out around about the coronavirus where people are selling health supplements and things at exorbitant prices. And we're doing this to let people know there's free things
exactly
that you can do that God's provided in His Word.
Right.
Now, you did say there's one thing you might buy over the counter at a typical drugstore that could help boost your immune system.
Yeah, the New England Journal did a study on the flu 3 weeks ago that was published, showing that if you take N-acetylcysteine, and of course this is a natural antioxidant that boosts our glutathione, it's very cheap, you can get it in any drugstore or pharmacy, two of those pills a day, which is 1,200 milligrams, if you're exposed to the flu, 3 out of 4 that were taking the NAC developed zero symptoms and developed antibodies against it. And that's off the charts in regards to anything else. In fact, better than the flu vaccine itself. by helping our own immune system do that. And it's pretty simple. It raises our glutathione levels and helps us in other ways too.
That's good. And so what's the name of it again, if they just go to the counter?
Yeah, N-acetylcysteine will be called NAC, because that's what it stands for, N-A-C. So it's really easy to remember, NAC.
Very good. Now, if people want to know more about the NEWSTART principles to help boost their immune system, and there's other health, many other health benefits, the website?
Yeah, NEWSTART.com. It's pretty easy. So NEWSTART.com, and you can get a lot more information.
And we've got something exciting for those that are watching. You know, we're not, everything here, we're providing free information so that people can get the truth out. That there was a magazine that Weimar printed in cooperation with Amazing Facts a few years ago, and it's dealing with the NEWSTART principles. And I think Dr. Nedley contributed to this. It's called Amazing Health Facts, 8 Bible Secrets to a Longer and a Stronger Life. Anybody that wants a free copy of this, if you want to know how you can boost your immune system and just other ways of improving your health, just click on the link at the bottom of this video. You get it for free, and we hope you'll pass it on to your friends. Well, anything else you want to add, Dr. Nedley, about you know, what we might keep in mind with what's happening? People are afraid. So should we be afraid? Or?
Well, I don't think there's really a reason to fear if our immune systems are good and we're healthy. Now, if we're unhealthy and we have something definitely suppressing our immune system, that might be a reason to stay inside and stay more isolated if it's out and about in the community. But for those of us who have healthy immune systems, and not that we're out there asking to come in contact with it so we develop our vaccine and antibodies, we still need to wash our hands. If we're putting our hands up to our face, those hands need to be washed immediately beforehand. If you mess up and you don't do that, I would recommend you carry around a little zinc lozenge, because zinc is toxic to the coronavirus on contact. So if you happen to, oh, wow, I just touched my face and I touched this surface over here, and if, you know, if it's infected, I'm doomed. No, zinc is toxic to the virus on contact, and those little zinc coldies or other zinc lozenges can be helpful. Exercise, aerobic exercise. The water therapy that is best is actually the contrast baths. When you end with cold, it is an immune stimulator. And so if you, in the morning, instead of just taking your hot shower, just alternate hot and cold, end with cold for a minute, and you'll warm up again right away, and that's very immune enhancing. Of course, the S for sunlight, the T for temperance, the A for fresh air, the R for rest, and the T for trust in God. If you have all those 8 principles, I'm not really worried about you if you were to come in contact with the coronavirus with the precautions that we've talked about, and we can still be a very positive influence in the world. But it does underscore the need that NEWSTART needs to go viral.
Yeah.
You know, because that's our protection.
Yeah. Following the principles God gave us for natural healing and health. And they're all outlined in God's word as well.
Exactly.
And I like that last T, especially, trust.
Yes.
You know, God doesn't want us to live in fear. He wants us to live in faith. Thank you so much. We appreciate your coming in. Folks, we hope this is helpful. And don't neglect, take a look at the NEWSTART.com website. And remember to download the free magazine.